Hello everyone, welcome to the new episode. Today, we'll talk about the newly released version 3.3.2 firmware. The software is still distributed in batches, although some users have had it installed and used for a long time, and they find the update quite useful. The main purpose of this firmware upgrade is to make third-party cloud storage easier to use and to introduce new capabilities that will help you work more efficiently. Let's look at it more closely now. First, we integrated third-party cloud storage into our library for the first time in NeoReader. Just click this button to choose a cloud storage and sign in. After that, you may download files directly from the cloud storage, and you can then open them in NeoReader and make notes on them. This functionality saves you from having to install third-party programs like Google Drive and Dropbox. You can immediately access the files by logging into the account. The integration will consume less CPU and RAM than the third-party software. Instead, it will make things flow more smoothly and in line with how you would normally work. But there are a few things to keep in mind when you use the built-in third-party cloud storage. Number one, our NeoReader can open 17 different types of BOOX files, like Word, PDF, and PowerPoint, but it's not compatible with Google Docs and a few other file types right now. Number two, if you want your notes on BOOX to sync between your BOOX devices, you must sign in to the same Onyx account. Number three, after the file has been updated in the cloud, click download to update it on your device. Number four, at the moment, you can only embed annotations and upload files in PDF to the integrated third-party cloud storage. This next update may be of particular interest to many individuals because it can assist you in reading books more effectively. We frequently use different annotation styles in books to separate information and later review them to organize our thoughts. And we can now do so on the NeoReader. Simply open a book, navigate to annotations to sort the annotations. Click the filter button in the bottom right corner. This allows you to easily group content with different annotation styles and review them quickly. You may have noticed that our device supports color highlights and underlines, which is especially useful on color e-readers. In NeoReader, you can now annotate the content of books with 16 different colors. And you can use various highlight styles, draw underlines, and take handwritten notes in various hues, so you can easily glance over the most important points. Our Notes app also got a lot of interesting new features in this update. One of these is the text note. When creating a new note, you have the option of selecting one of two styles. To create a new text note, click Text, then select a template and click Create. To enter text more easily in Text Note, you can utilize the software keyboard or a peripheral keyboard. You can change the text style while typing to arrange your notes. You can also insert links, images, attachments, and recordings at the same time to capture varied information and work more efficiently. Once you've completed your notes, you can sync them to the cloud or share them with others by email or a third-party app. It's important to note that you can only create and sync text notes after the latest version. So it's best to update all of your BOOX devices to the most recent firmware in order to enjoy Text Note. Aside from Text Notes, we've added a new feature to our handwritten notes. You can now insert specific note pages and document pages as links. To begin, open a handwritten note and select Insert. Take links to notes as an example. At this point, you can choose Link to a notepad or Link to a page and view the pages in thumbnails. You can also change the styles of the links. Following the new firmware update, our devices also provide many new system features, including Work Profile, which can help you better distinguish between work and personal accounts. Let's take Tab Ultra C as an example. Click Settings to go to Apps and Notifications. From here, enter the Work Profile settings, and you can choose to clone some applications to log in to different accounts. At the moment, Work Profile is only available for some models. You can check the change log on your device to see if this feature is available. We've improved cloud storage alongside version 3.3.2 since April of 2023. Each Onyx account's cloud storage has doubled from 5 GB to 10 GB, providing greater capacity for syncing notes and book annotations. You can view sync notes and book annotations in the cloud and mobile app, and you can keep working anywhere and at any time. Moreover, with the beta trial introduction, our OCR frequency has been increased from the previous 10 times to 300 times. You can use OCR in BOOX to identify the content of pictures, use text-to-speech, translate and underline. You can also use OCR in pictures to identify content. We hope you'll use the OCR feature more often. Let us know what you think by sending suggestions in settings and feedback. All of these mentioned features are the most important aspects of the new update. Which of these features do you prefer the most? Please share your thoughts and suggestions in the comments section below. Don't be concerned if you haven't yet upgraded to version 3.3.2 because our firmware is released in batches. You may check the update package by navigating to Settings, Firmware Update, and you can stay up to date on the current upgrade batch by following us on social media. I'm John from BOOX, and I'll see you next time.